Hello everyone, welcome back to Nokia Gaming. So, we are back again with the gameplay video of Ghost Recon Breakpoint. So, let's continue with hunting of Silverback. This silver back for the only one of the 4.1 kilometers is the really level up. Let's take that silence weapon. Alright, it is good. There's no doubt about it. Don't have other guns? Seriously? Range कम है तो बाकी सब better है। remote killer, press G to put out target or G to activate it. What? Okay, how can I get them? Remote killer, press G to put on target. I don't know how to use it actually. Yes, I time here. Now the time. Which can I know?
Silent.
It's a range gunner, I think. लॉजिक मुझे समझ में नहीं आया. अरे खाली एनिमीज ही घूमते हैं गाड़ी में, कहाँ जाते हैं एनिमीज? एनिमीज नॉर्मल पर्सन है ही नहीं.
Let me get a clean shot.
Glitch the glitch.
Hello. No need to fear. Hey, wait. Don't be afraid. Just want to talk.
What do you want?
I'm looking for Silverback.
You don't find Silverback. He finds you. He comes around a lot taking people away who aren't pulling their weight. A few days later, we'll find photos of their corpses.
Thanks. See you around.
This is a photo of Ocean Label, Silver Interest in the Black Place. This is a back on space and also Sunny Mountain. That's the old underground Cold War area. That's it. Will trigger game reload. No, it's not. Game reload. Kya hi karenge? Ab.
Shit.
Hear me now. करना रहता है अरे वायलेंट होता है कि आपको गाड़ी देना होगा फिर पहुंचाना है
bugged out. We're clear.
Hello. I'm not gonna hurt you.
I am tired of
you. Any clue how I can find this location? Thanks. Much obliged.
सिल्वर बैक कहीं और जगह पर है। ये नियर बाय कैसे है? ओके इसमें एटी मैप में दिखाई दे रहे हैं नहीं प्रेजेंट। अरे भाई बहुत डेडली लग रहा है। सामने कोई ड्रोन ना
Thank you.
Roger. Moving. Ready, Ghost Lead. Got the targets.
I see a breacher.
Nicely done.
अरे यार दबा तो रहे हैं यार बटन भी कभी कभी काम नहीं करेंगे तो ऐसे
I can't. He'll kill me.
Oh, yeah? What do you think I'll do?
You don't understand, man. He's totally crazy. Have you seen the photos?
Where is he?
All right. The province, they call Good Hope Mountain. We figured out he's got a place there.
Shot one kill. talking about? Drop to Commander. Just killed me a wolf.
Okay, he has grenade launcher.
Thank you.
I can hear them.
Roger that. Moving now. Rog, getting in position.
Set to take out the target.
Done and done.
All quiet.
There's a wolf there.
That's it. Stay back. Hostiles are on alert.
Time
to earn our money. Way to get it done.
Stop.
Embedded AI code.
Position. Set here, boss. Roger. Drone is locked.
Guy over there.
Target.
part of Auroa.
Thanks.
इतना डार्क हो गया ना भाई, नॉट एबल टू सी एनीथिंग.
Whatever is on here must be important.
Hey, bhai, isko toh bhai isse maar diya tha. General Silverback's plan, general entry. My old man used to tell me no one gets away clean in war, especially the innocent who ran to that. Locals are just another tool to use on the battlefield. You would think that ghosts would understand that if they are the best, but this one or second like it. He has no idea the trail of blood is falling leads right to me. He's feeling. We'll find out soon enough, and then with all mine, damn, my old man will be proud. This is a part of the note with the line from a poem written on the line reads that lead to the cave by an ancestral figure. And want to bring back the scope and maybe this. Switch scope B. Okay. Morris Fox Mafia, Grace Maddox Mafia, Anna Puri, Josiah Hill. Okay, 18 of the test on each idea. जाने का तो मन है बट मुझे हेलीकॉप्टर चाहिए, बिना व्हीकल के फायदा ही नहीं है। Control to evade, okay. And control to go.
You ever see yourself
something you might find interesting?
Yeah.
I'm here so new.
Just keep us safe.
Dr. Ragnar. Okay, P90 best on the corner.
Will you ever see this coming?
एक ही थाली में चट्टे बट्टे
You ready for this fight?
Stay out of trouble.
Focus is my forte.
Hello, Morris. There's so much to talk.
Fox, I would tell you something.
What? What's wrong?
Not all of the scientists made it. Some died in Herzog's prison.
But they were just scientists. These goddamn tyrants are always preying upon scientists. They treat us like they're little toys, using us to make themselves more powerful and then throwing us away like we're nothing.
They had to know there was some risk when they signed up to secretly develop weapons.
No. Scientists use science for good. It's the men who own it who choose to do evil.
You keep talking like Skelltech didn't know what it was doing. They made advanced weaponry out in the middle of nowhere where anyone could take it. For what? Profit? When companies make decisions like that, people die.
You have no idea what you're talking about. That's why Skell had to move the company out here in the first place, because people like you couldn't see the future.
Listen, this must be a lot to take right now. So why don't you get some rest? This fight isn't over. We still need you.
You're right. Thank you for saving the ones you could.
I saw there was a medical center at Mount Hodgson. Kind of a remote area for clinic, don't you think?
They do a lot of mining out there. But it's hours from the capital, so they needed an emergency care center that was local.
Are machines doing all the mining?
Most of it, but they still need humans calling the shots.
What kind of facilities do they have?
It's pretty basic. It's just designed to stabilize patients until they can get them to the main hospital in Liberty.
What can you tell me about the natural hazards control?
The NHC? How do you know about that?
I saw a station on Good Hope Mountain.
Ah, yes. That's our contingency.
Contingency?
We're out in the middle of nowhere. We need to be able to protect ourselves in the event of a natural disaster. Once the volcano on Gollum Island went active, well, we had to do something to make sure that everyone on Auroa felt safe.
And how exactly is Skell planning to keep people safe against a volcano?
Massive shelters, enough to house 30,000 people, the whole island. They're also designed to protect against hurricanes and tsunamis. The NHC is also in constant contact with a weather station to warn us about any threats. Like everything Skell does, he built it to the extreme.
And I'm willing to bet that means they're under heavy surveillance. You mentioned emails before. I'm assuming Auroa is connected to the internet.
Skell Tech is one of the most advanced tech companies in the world. Of course we have internet. We even have our own private network. Everything is connected to a next-gen, uncentralized 6G network. It's light years ahead of the traditional server client set.
6G network.
That's great, but I don't know what any of that means. Just tell me one thing. Can it connect to the mainland?
Sure. It's connected by an underwater cable that runs from Auroa to New Zealand. There's also a backup satellite connection in case the cable is ever damaged.
Great. Where can I find them?
You can't get to them as long as Sentinel Corp runs the island security. That's a dead end. They both run through the Auroa Internet Control Center. Unfortunately, it's way up in Silent Mountain. The only way to get to it is by flying shuttle. Once Sentinel took over, the first thing they did was take control of the center and ground the shuttles.
To keep people from getting a message out?
To control and filter messages coming both in and out. They own us here.
I saw what's left of the Skell Foundation and Infinity. I get why everyone's so worked up about terrorists.
That day left a big scar on this island. I don't think we've ever recovered.
Why attack the Foundation? They don't manufacture anything there. All the data inside must be backed up somewhere else.
It was the face of Skell Tech, the symbol of Skell's greatness.
Someone wanted to send a very clear message.
Over 40 souls were lost to send that message. Skell ordered the building not to be repaired. He wanted it to be a memorial.
Skell mentioned a data farm in Auroa. What can you tell me about it?
Shoot! What do you want to know? It's where Skell Tech stores everything. I mean, the whole place runs out of that data farm. The facility is so huge, they had to build it up on a mountainside in Silent Mountain.
Must be pretty important.
You have no idea. Skell wants to use it to store all of mankind's knowledge for all eternity. I mean, everything, from how to start a fire with a couple of rocks to ion thrusters. And he wants to make it available to everyone across the globe. The complete democratization of knowledge.
How could he possibly get all of mankind's knowledge in the first place?
Easy. The internet. It's all there. We just had to write the proper algorithms to pull the information out and classify it. It was a huge operation.
Was.
Well, now the Sentinel shut the internet off, we can't harvest information anymore.
Skell runs all the industry on Auroa. What about the people who live on the island? Is he in charge of their lives too?
Oh no. The people of Auroa ran their own government. The capital is in the City of Liberty. We used to hold elections and have a parliament that represents the people and creates the laws on the island.
And what happens when people break these laws?
Well, we have our own court where people can plead their case.
But Skell Tech pays for all of this, right?
They do. They provide whatever the citizenry ask for.
As long as it meets their agenda.
Anyone on Auroa who disagrees with Skell Tech's agenda is free to leave.
Is that Sentinel's policy?
No. No. Now that they've taken over, they've shut down everything.
I guess the government of Auroa didn't have so much power after all. I need anything you can tell me about Auroa, especially anything involving any terrorist activity.
Well, about a year ago, there was an explosion at the Skell Foundation in Infinity. Destroyed half the building. We lost a lot of people. Good people. Friends.
How did Skell respond?
He wasn't the same after that. You know, his wife died in 9/11? He got depressed. He turned paranoid. He didn't know who he can trust anymore. That's when he brought Sentinel onto the island. Things got a lot worse when they showed up.
Recognize her from Skeltech's public announcement videos. Who is she?
Her? That's Ayanna Puri. She's Skeltech's CFO. She's incredibly driven and loyal. She's been CFO for over 10 years. Hell, for business purposes, she is Skeltech.
Was she close to Skell?
Oh, extremely. They used to work together at the head office in Infinity.
If they were so close, what's she doing helping Sentinel?
I have no idea.
Open your eyes, it's right there in front of you. She's working with Sentinel because she was tired of being number two. This is her shot to become the queen of Skeltech.
But what could she have wanted? She had everything. She was one of the most respected women in business.
She might have had everything, but she was still in Skell's shadow. Now, there's no one in front of her. Thanks for the help, Fox. I'll see you later.
Thanks for the help, Fox.
Got in an argument with a Sentinel soldier. I thought they were going to pull their gun at us.
Match shows a lot to me.
I don't get how the drones aren't seeing you here.
Well, that's all Jericho. Set up special nets at the openings that hide us from the sensors. Cave walls, take care of the rest. It's a little smarter than I am, so I'll let you ask her if you need more technical details.
Yeah, thanks. How's it feel having Skell here?
He's just a person. Granted, not exactly my kind of people. Part of me is disappointed. The man can talk. He even had me starting to believe he was different.
But then came the drones.
I wonder how many times in his career he's claimed more credit than he deserved. Now all he wants to do is give it away. Hopefully he makes himself useful. Time will tell. In the meantime, I'll talk with Fox instead.
Fair enough. A lot of new faces around.
Yours included.
It's good of you. Sharing your food, patching us up, giving us a place to rest. I know it must be a strain.
Something on your mind?
I'm wondering, how long is this place gonna be a secret?
You think I haven't thought of that? Or what happens if one of these victims turns out to be a Sentinel soldier? I owe my people. I know that. I'll do whatever I have to protect them, first, last, and only if it comes to that.
I get it. But first, you have to survive. If I was you, I would have left the island when Skeltech moved in.
Skell wasn't so bad at the start.
Until he made killer drones and turned the island into an exclusion zone?
Obviously.
Yep. Technology can be a pain in the ass.
Yep.
You take care of your people like a good NCO.
They're their own people. We've no leaders here. Even so, I guess most people do look to me.
Probably what Uncle Sam saw in you, I'd bet. Where'd you serve?
26th Expeditionary. I was infantry in Liberia and the Balkans. UN support off the Somali coast.
NCO pension didn't suit you?
I got tired of fighting over oil. So when the good old US of A stopped pretending we had any other purpose, so did I. Served out the rest of my enlistment and decided to stay.
You homesteaders must hate Skeltech's automated farms.
I'm sure some of us would jump at the idea, so long as it meant they were still off-grid.
Come on. Seriously? I thought you guys were about living off the Earth, being one with nature and all that stuff.
Where'd you get that hippie crap? People got different reasons for being here, Nomad.
What are yours?
They're mine, is what they are.
So is living in a cave your idea of homesteading?
With Sentinel stomping through the wild, we needed someplace off-grid. Wasn't always like this, you know. Used to be better.
Yeah?
Sure. Even with scale and everything. Won't say it was like we were swapping recipes and PTA carpooling, but we got along. There was respect. Things took a turn after the bombing, though.
Got bad, huh?
Started with the curfews and checkpoints. Sentinel soldiers beating people, snatching them up. It's like some kind of nightmare. We had to run. We ain't cut out to fight a war.
And the tighter Sentinel's grip got, the worse it got.
We're simple people, but we're living like vermin, and these soldiers are hunting us down. We hide here, and we make the best of it.
Yeah, I've seen this before. Too many times.
I'm sure you have.
So what happened here?
What didn't happen? Skeltech is utopia. This place was paradise before they showed up with their toys.
Come on. Digging in the dirt, worrying if you're gonna have a good crop, weathering hurricanes without any infrastructure, that's paradise?
It was ours. It meant something. These people came here and brought the devil with them.
People always bring the devil with them.
Those people out there, they brought a few extra, and they can have them. We're gonna weather the storm here.
So you've got your people, but screw the rest of them.
I got enough people to think about.
Mads, what do your people know about the wolves? They don't seem to fit into Sentinel so well.
They're all sons of bitches.
Yeah, but I don't get the chain of command.
Trey Stone runs Sentinel. His men ain't always the cream of the crop. The wolves are Walker's troops. Now they scare me. They're motivated, well-trained, and efficient.
I've seen that firsthand.
Gossip is that Stone and Walker don't really get along. I don't think Walker's the play well with others type.
You have no idea. Between Stone, Walker, and Paula Madeira, Jay Skell doesn't seem that good at keeping friends.
Nope.
I guess a rich guy like that, big tech boss, everybody must be wanting something from him.
Maybe. But if folks keep turning on you, sooner or later you gotta ask yourself what part you played.
Nah, you got used.
Dr. Madeira seems to feel like she's the one got used.
She's an engineer, so she's not a doctor.
Does that mean she's wrong?
I guess not. I'll tell you, AI is running way too much out there.
When people started putting it all over their homes, that Internet of Things crap, That's when all doubt about homesteading left my mind.
We're two steps away from letting AI make all the big decisions.
Who do you think is making all them micro trades that move the stock market up and down? Who do you think decides if you get that home loan? Who analyzes all the population data that decides government policy?
You've thought about this.
Maybe you should think about it more. How much AI are you carrying onto the battlefield?
How are Fox and Harmony holding up?
Bit of a miracle they made it this far. That man couldn't find his nose without a mirror.
He took a big chance trying to get off the island.
And he's got a kid to think about. Things go south, he can't take care of himself, let alone her.
Nobody does it alone.
No, you're right. I've known Fox and Harmony for a little while. I just worry about them. They know they have a home here with us.
Maybe you need to remind Fox. Put him at ease.
Yeah.
You don't look like Skeltech employees.
No. I used to be a Marine at the naval station here. Some of the folks you see, like Maria, my old lady, they lived on the station with their families. When the Navy shut the place down in the 90s, a few of us stayed and homesteaded. We worked a long time to make a place for ourselves on Auroa.
And now, you're in Sentinel's way.
Most of my people are holing up here for now. I ain't been home in a dog's age, but I'll stand by any man or woman in green. You soldiers can stay as long as you don't cause trouble. And you lend a hand.
We appreciate it. Lucky you found this place.
Rowan Brown knew about this place for a while. We figured sacred ground always makes good sanctuary.
It's pretty damp, though.
It's still a work in progress, all right? We've managed to stay under the radar so far. With all of you, our people, a bunch of Skeltech employees. I don't think you've got room to complain.
Hey, I'm not complaining. This place is great. It'd be a pretty island without all the military contractors and killer drones.
Used to be. I'd get some leave and just walk. I'd spend whole weeks just walking around with a pack on my shoulder.
Well, I'm probably getting my share of sightseeing.
These islands have changed hands so much, it's like a time capsule. I keep telling myself, one day, I'll get back out there, just see it all again before I'm too old to make the trip. Then again, who knows how far I'd get now.
I'm sorry about those folks who died trying to make it to the Wasp.
Appreciate you saying so, I guess. I ain't left Auroa since I decided to stay. Most of us are homesteading here. We made a point of cutting ourselves off from everything.
Small price to pay for paradise.
Once. But now we can't leave.
So you pay a higher price to take it back?
Maybe. But these people aren't warriors. Whatever survived, I get the feeling it wouldn't be the same. Auroa'd be ruined. Just another place where people died.
I'll talk to you later.
See ya.
I'll talk to you later.
See ya.
I was trading gear with the outcasts. Well, they seemed all right, no matter what anybody says.
Hello, Jericho.
What's with the fancy net there on Erewhon's crater?
Well, it's hardly a net, but yes, it is fancy. It's bleeding-edge, multi-layered camouflage equipment that blocks visibility with surrounding environmental patterns. More importantly, it fools the drones. It's how I keep Erewhon hidden and virtually impossible to find.
So it works the way a chameleon would, blending into the background.
A little more advanced, but yes. The fabric uses a signature management system that disrupts thermal patterns, infrared wavelengths, and radio emissions so drones can't run their recognition algorithms. It won't fool the human eye. I mean, if somebody was looking at a drone feed, they might notice something weird, but...
Nobody can check thousands of hours of video feed on Auroa.
Right. It makes hiding things from drones pretty easy. They can't respond to what they don't see. It was developed by Skelltech. Luckily, I just so happen to know how to hijack it. Now Erewhon can remain safe for at least a little while.
I like your style, Jericho. All these drones must use a massive amount of power.
We use more electricity than most third world countries.
So if we pull the plug, we can shut the whole operation down.
There's no plug. The whole island is powered by a diverse renewable power grid. There are multiple power sources and no one source powers everything. And all the power sources are renewable. None of them need fuel.
So you built a lethal drone army and gave it unlimited power. No one thought that might be a problem.
Skell insisted our power came from environmentally friendly sources. We have the cleanest power grid on Earth, also the most expensive. Maybe people like you are the reason Skell had to build his utopia way out here in the middle of nowhere.
How many of these renewable power sources are there?
There's a massive solar panel farm outside Liberty and wind turbines on the west coast. There are also two oceanic geothermal plants in the channels between the islands. Those are powered by cold water from Antarctica and warm water from the Pacific.
There must be some kind of battery where they store all the excess power.
Just north of Liberty, there's a dam. Inside are flywheel capacitors. That's where the energy is stored.
Why couldn't we just destroy the power grid? There's no way to disrupt the swarms by just smashing the electric box.
This power grid is a model for a sustainable future, and all you want to do is destroy it? Besides, you can't knock it out. It's designed to have backups for backups. Even if all that fails, we have energy stored in the flywheel capacitors. The lights are never going off on Auroa.
That's the scary thing about this World 2.0 you built. It can't be rebooted. What kind of air traffic do you get on the island?
Before the perimeter of drones made leaving the island impossible, the only people flying in or out were investors or vacationers. To be honest, we've never had much air traffic. Why do you ask?
I saw an airport earlier. We might be able to land a bird in there.
To evacuate people?
Or explore. I'm just spitballing here.
The Auroa airport near Infinity has the big runway. That's where all the international flights come in.
Any smaller airstrips? Somewhere that can land helos.
Try Liberty Airport. We use it for internal jumper flights. If you're snooping around there, just be careful. Sentinel uses both of them, so they're crawling with security.
How do you fit into this whole Skelltech design?
I was the head of the Civic Engineering Department. Guess you could say I resigned over creative differences regarding Titan.
So you had something to do with designing the infrastructure here on Auroa?
Sort of. I build on top of what the New Zealand and U.S. military started. Every culture has to do that. Build on top of existing infrastructure. The older the culture, the more infrastructure is already in place, the harder it is to modernize. That's why Europe is such a mess.
Why not just tear it up and start over?
Once you build something, like roads, you don't want to unbuild them. Plus, Skell wanted to keep all the existing structures in place as a way to preserve the island.
That seems like a pain in the ass.
I don't mind a challenge. That's what makes me so good at what I do.
So I guess your roads are going to be a problem for the next person that comes here to design infrastructure.
I doubt it. By the time my roads need to be reworked, people will be flying around Auroa on jetpacks.
I'll see you around.
Sure. I'll be seeing you.
There's a lot of chatter about them since the bombing, but they were the first to see the threat of Sentinel. They were the first to fight back.
The truth is, we need them. We need to help out our sick people. But we need to make sure that we stay healthy. So use the proper sanitary procedures.
I Let's go, boy.
Thank you.
Hi.
Just stop with this
shit. No need to be afraid. Any clue where I might find this equipment?
There's somewhere I know you can look.
Thanks. Take care of yourself.
Any intelligence we can find.
That's it.
Let them jump on us again. Stay focused! Thank you.
There might be some intel here.
Good chance her neighbor was the last person to have had eyes on Madeira. Follow the breadcrumbs.
Let me get a clean shot.
Maneuvering now, boss.
Set to take out the hostile.
Prepared to fire.
Okie dokie. All eliminated.
Hey, pal. I'm looking for your neighbor, Paula Madeira.
Oh. I haven't seen her around for a while. She just left one day. I heard Sentinel has a new engineer continuing her work.
Who knows where Paula went?
Nah. There was some guy, Dagaro. She used to meet in Auroa's parliament. It sounded like he was one of those protest kids.
Thanks.
Investigate anything that seems useful.
We got possible enemies in the area, so everybody stay alert.
Hostiles eliminated. Sweet shot, Goose Lead.
Checkpoint wipe for India. This helicopter is fast.
Shot.
Tell me everything.
There's nothing left. I've already told you everything. Please, just let me go.
Detention center photo. This is a photo of the prison where those captured by the engineer are being held. The prison itself looks like an impenetrable fortress. The idea of such an imposing prison seems strange in a lush utopia that is Auroa. Can see it from where I am.
Don't scream. Who's putting up these posters?
That's it. I've told you everything. I don't know anymore.
He died. Oh my god.
Aware of our presence. We need to gather any intel we can find.
Standing. We're compromised. Ain't nobody here.
No, no, no.
That's the stuff.
Find them.
All over that shit. I'll find you, you son of a bitch.
Don't let them get away. Keep looking.
Hostiles are here somewhere. We'll find them.
Got a hostile.
Hostiles, moving in! It's on! I'm having it!
Side.
I'll bet there's good intel here.
Nice, ghost lead.
Thank you.
that, Ghost Lead.
I'm not so sure. Who knows how many of them are actually there? Impossible to monitor.
Yeah, nothing out here.
We're not gonna find a damn thing out here.
They are not paying me enough for this.
Negative contact. What the shit?
Watch the air drone.
What the?
Ooh, nice. Let's get it on.
You got more to say, buddy?
I said everything I know. Everything.
Anything about where they took her.
Enemies hit!
Smoked him!
Keep your
eyes, Gunner.
That's it. She has seems very, very lucky. Okay, Diacolo.
You know Paul and Madeira? The drone engineer.
What are you saying?
She makes drones. Like the ones flying all over the island killing folks.
Hey, I don't care what you heard. There's no way she'd work for Sentinel. She's one of us. She's brave as hell, and she's an outcast.
So why'd she make drones in the first place?
Who the hell are you, man?
Relax. I'm a friend. I was on one of the helicopters that crashed.
Let's get to a safe house. We can talk there.
What's your name?
Nomad. What's yours?
Degoro Ito.
The hell are you doing in the most technologically advanced place on Earth if you don't... I don't like technology.
Enjoy, hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.